lot of times, you know, people say, well, they shouldn't have been doing drugs. But teenagers, they do things. They try things. They don't think twice about what they're taking they're going to die from.
So just giving you nationally what's going on, about 100,000 people die from overdoses each year or accidental poisonings each year. And the vast majority of those are fentanyl-related or opioid-related.
Fernando Sanchez, he was my only child. He was 17 years old. He loved music, real smart kid. He was funny, quick thinker. He had no fear. He lived life like nothing's gonna happen to me, pretty much, like most teenagers.
Jacob was born August 21st, 1996. He was a delightful little boy, brought us joy. We enrolled him in all the local activities. He was in Little League, Boy Scouts. He had lots of friends. He was the youngest of my three children, my only son. We lost him November 28th, 2020, Thanksgiving weekend. Toxicology report said that he passed from acute fentanyl. Xanax and fentanyl were the only things he found, they found in his system. He had enough fentanyl in that one pill to kill six people.
So on March 26, 2020, he decided to go with some friends to buy some Xanax off somebody that they knew. So they contacted him through social media, through Snapchat. What he thought he was buying wasn't Xanax at all, it was Tramadol and fentanyl. The other two boys that he was with, they just fell asleep. And my son was the one who passed out of the three. It's been hard. He's my only child, and you know, one day you're a mom and the next day you're not.
We looked on his phone when the deputies were still there, and we noticed that he had made a phone call the night that he had come home, and a couple texts, and on there was, you know, thanks for the Xanax. Thanks, they called them Zans, I believe, you know. He came through. And so we knew that he had gotten Xanax from that young man.
The vast, vast majority of the young people don't know the effects of fentanyl mixed in with some of the other drugs that they're taking. Or they had no idea that the drug that they purchased, that they thought was a legitimate prescription drug, turned out to be a drug tainted with fentanyl.
You think you're buying a Xanax or a Percocet or, you know, some other type of pill. You hear it on the radio, you hear it in the songs. You know, it sounds like a good time, and really you don't know what you're taking unless it's from your doctor, it's prescribed, it has your name on it. The thing about fentanyl is it's really, really addictive. So if you do live, you need to get into some type of treatment to get help getting off of it.
There is nothing safe on the street. And my warning to parents and students is don't do anything. And if you know someone who's doing it, carry Narcan.
Narcan is the one antidote for someone who's overdosed on any opioid, including fentanyl. It's quick acting. It lasts only about 2 to 3 minutes. So they may need a second dose depending on how severe the ingestion or the injection that they received of the fentanyl or any other opiate might have gotten into their system.
For those people who might have a mood disorder like my son did, get that help you need. Don't take no for an answer and look for the resources out there that can help with mood disorder so that using is not something to turn to instead. My son's girlfriend sent me a photo of five young men in high school, and they say now that every 2 out of 5 pills is a fake counterfeit pill. And in that photo of these five beautiful young men, 2 are dead. My son and little Joe. And if that doesn't really say the statistic of 2 in 5, I don't know what else would.
You know, I thought I was gonna bring him home. I thought I was gonna bring him home. And he was gone that quick. There's nothing that I could do to get my son back. My son's gone. But if just one kid was saved from hearing his story, then